Well, I had just finished a novel about the Civil War in Northern Virginia, which I know more about than I ever thought I would ever have to know in order to write Red Moon at Sharpsburg. But you can't write and read about the Civil War and avoid Lincoln. And I did try. I really tried because I thought Lincoln was a bit of a cliche. This man was the most written about person in all of history. I think even more than Jesus Christ, you can find more books on Lincoln. And I thought, well, this has been done, and I would have to be a very, very finicky scholar in order to dig up anything new about him. I think the genesis of Lincoln and His Boys came from a book I found by accident called Lincoln as We Knew Him, by Harry Holzer, the great scholar at Columbia University, who has written several books on Lincoln and the Lincoln family. Lincoln as We Knew Him is a book by the people who actually knew Lincoln, and it is their memoirs of him and their reminiscences of him as a man as they knew him. And some of it's very positive, and some of it is by people who didn't like him, and some of it is by Dennis Hanks, who was his half-brother and was certifiably crazy. He really was. And Dennis Hanks managed to foist upon our later generations all kinds of myths about Lincoln's childhood and young manhood, which I think Dennis probably made up himself. And so what we have is a mythology of Lincoln that amounts to Stations of the Cross of Abraham Lincoln. And I thought, well, in reading farther in his life, almost none of this is true. And what I discovered that was amazing and so contemporary and shows the power of an individual is that Lincoln really, truly was an abused child. Today, he would have gone to a Title I school, if that, for 9 non-consecutive months in his entire life. And he would have had free lunch and free breakfast and shoes because he had nothing. He grew up in a house with 3 walls, the fire being on the outside because they couldn't afford a chimney. And then they moved to another house and another. His father was an itinerant worker who picked up odd jobs. He was also a drunk, and he was also very abusive. Lincoln lost his mother early. He was very fortunate in his father's choice of stepmother, which probably saved his life. However, the telling detail, and there's always something in history that will give you the clue of the entire childhood. Shortly before Lincoln went to the White House, not called the White House then, by the way, called the Executive Mansion, went to Washington as president, his father lay dying and requested Lincoln's presence. And Lincoln said, no, he wouldn't go to his dying father's deathbed. And his father recovered somewhat, but then died shortly after. And would Lincoln erect a tombstone to his father? No. Now, I don't want to read too much into that, and so I simply put that fact into my book, Lincoln and His Boys, and allow the reader to think, what sort of relationship, what sort of childhood did this man have, and how, out of 9 months of non-consecutive schooling in the man's entire life, with the exception of reading law, as he did before he became an attorney, how did this man managed to speak and write in the years 1860 to 1865 far more effectively, more eloquently, and more magnificently than any individual in world history until Churchill and maybe FDR. And that is a long span of time. That is 70, 80 years. This man from nowhere in Kentucky put our nation on the map as a serious country that was united and spoke so eloquently that no one matched him till Winston Churchill. How did such a miracle happen? And then I knew I had to write about him. And what I read about him was what kind of a wonderful father he was.